Carol simply blinks her eyes. Blinks her eyes means to take eyebrows up and down. Okay, and she drops her head, means she is avoiding the man's question. And quickly she asks, what do you mean? Okay, you know, what are you, what race? So the man, now he becomes very clear that I want to know to which race you belong to, a black or a white. Carol's mouth drops. Race? What is that? She doesn't understand. Yet, she senses that the man is asking a bad question. She wishes her mom and dad were there. They could tell what race meant. So she tried to be ignorant. She said, what is the meaning of race? Okay. And then she senses that the man is actually asking a very bad question. Like in Hindi we say, na, if somebody asks a man, what is your salary? And if somebody asks a woman, what is your age? These two questions are impolite. We are not supposed to ask any man about his salary and any lady about her age. And in foreign countries, asking whether you belong to the white race or the black race is again a very indecent kind of question. So Carol didn't want to answer that indecent kind of question. And she wished that her mom, dad were there. They could have answered this stupid man nicely. That doll of yours is black, Henry Norton says. That's a Negro doll. That's race, Negro. What's your race? So the man is crossing his limits now. He says, see, look at the color of your doll. It's a black doll, and blacks are known as Negroes. Fine? Page number 27. Why are you late? Anyway, join the meeting now. You are too late. 40 minutes have already passed. So the man said, see, look at the color of your doll. It's a black color, and people having black complexion are known as Negro. So what are you? The question still confuses her. Put it this way, the man says, what is your father? So the girl is trying to be innocent. Okay, so the man is getting more simpler and simpler. He says, you don't know the meaning of a Negro. Okay. So he explains in another way. What is your father? A black or a white? The question baffles her. Baffles her means confuses her. What is her father? He is her dad. So she says, what is my father? He's my dad. He is her dad, and every Sunday morning he makes pancakes for, turn the page, the whole family, and lets Carol pour hot syrup on them, and afterwards he tells her stories. So she says, what is my father? My father is my father. Every Sunday he makes pancakes for us, and I'm supposed to pour the syrup means syrup in Hindi you say chashni, okay, meetha chashni on the pancakes, and afterwards tells me stories. That is my father. Norton leans towards Carol. Say you had a coloring book. What color would you make your dad? So now he is trying to get more simpler. He says, supposing you have a coloring book and you want to color your father. What color will you give to your father? I never use just one color. So the girl, she is very smart. She says, no, I don't. Every time I don't use the same color to color my father. Okay, what color would you make his face? So the man puts another way. He says, okay, if you are drawing your father's face, what color would you paint your father's face? The girl says, brown. And your mother, Carol, imagines a blank page. What would she put in her mother's face? She has to put something in there. She can't leave it blank. I don't know. So now when the man asks, what color will you paint your mother's face? The girl imagines her mother's face, but the page is blank. Okay? And so she says, I don't know. Sure you do, Mrs. Norton says. How would you color your mother's face? So the lady now gets up. She says, you know what color is your mother's face. Come on, tell me. What color will you apply to your mother's face? So the girl, she says, yellow. Carol sees Mr. and Mrs. Norton look at each other. Is your mother Chinese? Mrs. Norton asks. So now husband, wife, they looked at each other, getting some image of their of her parents. So Mrs. Norton, she asks Carol, is your mother a Chinese woman? No. Are you sure you would color her yellow? So now she says, are you sure you will color your mother's face yellow? Now Carol says, no. Earlier she said yes. Now she says no. Are you all able to hear me, children? But don't talk. But don't talk between, otherwise I'll... Who is this talking with a manly voice? Some elder person has entered. Tell your parents to move out from that room. So this time she says, no, I won't color my mother's face yellow. What else might you color her? What else? Carol feels ashamed at her stupidity. A tear races down her cheek. Red, she says finally. So now every time they are asking for the color of her mother's face, and once she said yellow, the other time she said no, I won't apply yellow color. So they asked her again, then what color will you apply to your mother's face? So she starts crying. A tear drops down her cheek. And then she says, I would like to apply red color to my mother's face. Red? You can't color a face red. Is your mother white? Is she like me? Her face, is it the same color as mine? So they say, you cannot color any face red. Okay, is she white as my face? The lady is asking. Yes. And your father is brown? Carol nods. So she says, yes, my mother's face is red and my father's face is round. Okay. When you say brown, do you mean he is a Negro? So now they ask, when you are saying that you are going to color your father's face brown, do you mean that he is a Negro? Negro here means the black. Okay. Yes, of course, her father is a Negro. If Mrs. Norton wanted to know all along if her dad was a Negro, why didn't she ask? Just ask. So now the story is, this girl is a product of a pair of husband and wife, where husband is a Negro, means a black man, and her mother, born in Chicago, is a white woman. So now Carol is wondering, why didn't this man ask me earlier whether your father is a Negro or not, just to cut short. So you are mixed, Mrs. Norton says. You are a mulatto. Mulatto means a person with one black parent and the other one white parent. Okay, Preeti, hearing me? Okay. So now the Mrs. Norton, she says, okay, so you belong to a mixed breed. Okay. Means you are a mulatto, means a product of parents of different races. Okay, one is a black person and the other is a white person. Okay, Carol's lip quivers, means they shakes. Okay, what is a mulatto? Why do they keep asking her what she is? She isn't anything. So now she is wondering why these people are so much interested in me. Okay. Who am I? It's not a question for them to know. So is that it? You are a mulatto. You know that mulatto is, don't you? Haven't your parents taught you that word? So now, again, the husband and the wife, they are after that girl's blood. Okay. They again started, don't you know from the beginning that you are a mulatto, that your parents belong to two different races? Your parents didn't tell you that you are a mulatto. Again, mulatto is an indecent word. Nobody should utter that word. It's a bad word, like a Negro. Okay. Still, the educated husband and wife, they are using it so many times. Preeti, are you able to hear me? Hello? Preeti? Yes. Please don't touch your phones, otherwise the other children are distracted. My voice is not so much clear, otherwise I will mute everybody. Meghna, can you hear me? Okay, fine. Approaching with a cart of juice, the stewardess looks up and smiles at Carol. That gives her a rush of courage. So now again the air hostess comes in with a cart of juice. Okay, she smiles at Carol. Okay. And her smile, yes, Ujjwal. Ujjwal, what do you want to ask, Ujjwal? You raised your hand. don't raise your hand until and unless you want to ask something, Ujjwal. Don't go to that option of raising hands until and unless you are asked. So, because the air hostess was smiling at her, she again, Nitin Sharma is raising hand. यानी बैठ के आप लोग मोबाइल से खेल रहे हो इंस्टेड ऑफ हियरिंग द स्टोरी. उज्ज्वल एंड नितिन माइनस टू फ्रॉम फाइव मार्क्स ऑफ योर सब्जेक्ट एनरिचमेंट एक्टिविटी. नो यू डोंट हैव एनी परमिशन टू आस्क एनीथिंग. नो यू कांट आस्क एनीथिंग इन बिटवीन. वट एवर क्वेरीज यू हैव वी हैव गिवन टू ऑल आर इन द इवनिंग सेशन. Don't ask anything. For your questions only, we are working in the evening also. So, because the air hostess was smiling at her, that gave him the strength. Okay? The feeling that she was not all alone in the plane. Leave me alone, she screams at Mrs. Norton. So when she got the motherly feeling from that air hostess smiling at her, she gained courage and simply screamed out loudly, leave me alone. Okay, she screamed at the woman, Mrs. Norton. Passengers stared. So everybody got conscious. They started staring at them both. The stewardess spills a drink. Mrs. Norton sits back hard in her seat, her hands raised, fingers spread. Carol sees people watching. So when she shouted at Mrs. Norton, everybody, all the passengers, they started looking at her. So the air hostess, she puts the liquid in the glass and Mrs. Norton sits back on the seat with a stiff hands and fingers. Turn the page. Why do you keep asking me if my dad is Negro? Yes, he is Negro. Okay, okay, Negro, Negro, Negro. Now she got irritated. Okay, and she says, why you have been asking me the same question whether my dad is a Negro? Yes, he is a Negro. Okay, calm down, Mrs. Norton says, reaching over. So now Mrs. Norton, she tries to calm the girl, Carol. Okay? Don't touch her, the stewardess says. So Mrs. Norton, she tries to make the girl calm by touching her. So the air hostess, she quickly says, don't touch the girl. You are not supposed to touch any passenger. Who are these people? Someone says from across the air. Imagine talking to a child like that, and in 1970, so somebody from the aisle, aisle means the passage between the two rows of seats, okay? So across that aisle, one person puts the question, who are these people sitting with that girl? Okay, and talking to a child like that, whether the father is Negro or not, and that too in the year 1970, means the modern age. Fine. One woman sitting in front of Carol stands up and turns around. Would you like to come and sit with me, little girl? So one lady sitting ahead of Carol, she stands, look at the back and ask Carol whether she would like to sit on her seat. Okay, just to avoid that thing. Okay, no, Carol shouts, I don't like all these questions. she keeps asking me how I would color my parents in a coloring book. Why do you keep asking me that? So she says, no, I change my seat. You gonna yuk? Who is this? Now I'm going to mute everybody since I cannot bear this intolerance. Now nobody can hear me. I have muted all. Preeti, if you are able to hear me, just raise your hand. Preeti, just raise your hand, Preeti. Meghna. Okay, that means you can hear me. Okay, nod your head. Okay, fine. That means you all are able to hear me. I have muted everybody because of one stupid child. Okay? So just sit and listen. Now, if you don't listen, if you don't hear my voice, that is your problem now. Because of one child, everybody has to bear this. So Carol, she says that she doesn't want to change her seat and she kept on cursing the family. She says that she doesn't understand all these questions. Okay, why she keeps on asking me how would I color my parents in a coloring book? Okay, why do you want to ask all these questions? Mrs. Norton pleads with Carol to stop. Now, Mrs. Norton, she is feeling ashamed. She's pleading Carol to stop cursing and shouting loudly because everybody was hearing her shouts. How would you like it if that happened to you? Carol says. So what are you anyway? And what are your parents? How would you color them? Well, I don't care. I don't even care. So now Carol shouts that I don't like this question to be asked again, that how would I color my hairs? Okay. Network issue. How will you feel when somebody comes and asks you about your parents, about your race? How would you color your parents? Okay. So she said that she also didn't like all these things. How would you like to come and sit with me? The stewardess says, smiling. I'll make you a special drink. Have you ever had a Shirley Temple? So now the air hostess, she comes to her rescue and asks whether Carol would like to sit with her. Okay? And she won't mind making a fresh drink, a special drink for Carol, a Shirley Temple. It's a kind of drink, like you have mojito. Mojito pite ho ghar mein, like our nibu ki shikanji. Okay, that is a kind of mojito. The spelling is J, not H, but we pronounce it H, mojito. The spelling is M-O-J-E. Okay? But we pronounce it mojito. Okay? Carol nods enthusiastically. Already she feels better. So she nods her head in a happy manner because the stress had already gone. When you just pour out all the anger shouting at somebody, you feel relaxed, okay? So her anger was over by that time. So she said she won't mind sitting with the air hostess anyway, okay? Already? Okay. Clutching Amy, she passes by the Nortons who swing their legs to let her out. So she simply clutches her doll, Amy, and starts walking out of the seat passage. And the Nortons, both husband and wife, they were swinging their legs to make way for her to get out from there. "My God," Carol hears Mrs. Norton tell her husband. "Talk about sensitive." So now, Mrs. Carol had put all the blame upon her husband. Okay? She said, okay, see the repercussion of asking a small girl about her race. I told you not to ask anybody about his or her race. But you did. Now you have to bear it. Though she was equally a participant in asking all those stupid questions. But she put all the blame on her husband. Okay. So what is the moral of the story? We are living in a modern age where the color of the skin does not matter. Okay, we have to treat all human beings alike. Okay. Now please take a pencil in your hands to tick the word meanings. Pencil in your hands. Some network issues are there. Please wait for some time. Let me get connected to you people. Keep on waiting. We are going to connect with you soon. कनेक्टिंग इशू आ गया है, दिलीप को भेज सकते हैं? Please wait, we are trying to connect to you. Connecting problem aa gaya aur ye screen aa gaya. Pehle off karo ise. Recording off karo. Which one? Okay.
गया आज।
तो अभी आपकी मीटिंग ऑफ हो गई ना?
मीटिंग ऑफ हो गई तो फिर से स्केड्यूल करूँ?
हाँ
अच्छा ठीक है, बंद कर दो। मीटिंग में ये लिख के क्यों आ
रहा है? वो तो बीच में वो टाइम डलाओगे ना?
नहीं
आप ले रही हैं या मतलब
दूसरी मीटिंग ले ली, लेकिन
ले ली तो कंटिन्यू करो या फिर नेट डाउन हो रहा है आपका?
नेटवर्क
प्रॉब्लम आती है
इसलिए कनेक्ट नहीं हो पा रहा है। मैंने दूसरा भी स्केड्यूल कर दिया, फिर वेट करूँ?
हाँ वेट करो, उसके जो चल रही है अभी वाली टाइमिंग क्या था उसका?
टाइम तो 40 मिनट का स्लॉट था।
कल भी आया था ऐसे कॉल मेरे।
मीटिंग अलर्ट एंड अदर मीटिंग वो चल ही रही है अभी।
चल रही है वो,
उसको एंड कर सकता है। यस वो है। समझ में नहीं आ रहा, समझने में क्या दिक्कत है बेटा? अभी बेटा मीटिंग चल रही है, ठीक है? Hello, can you hear me again? Okay, there was some network issue. On your video cameras, please.
ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन योर वीडियो कैमरास. Please on your video cameras, everybody. Yes, Meenal, can you hear me? Okay, now pencils in your hands.